It's not whether you're rich or poor. It's the choice you have. This rich man had no compassion for a beggar. By all indications, his works showed evidently that he had no faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Because James makes it clear, if you have genuine and true faith, it will be manifested by your good works. Mm-hmm. So he had no genuine faith in Jesus. Not but Lazarus did not go to heaven, paradise, at a time. Because he was poor. It's my in Jesus. John 3:36, very clear. So many verses in the Bible. It says in John 3:36, he who has the Son has life, but he who doesn't have the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides. So it's by faith in Jesus Christ. Okay, that's number one clarification. Number two. I believe choice in life is a determining factor of our eternal destinies. Make the choice while you are still alive and wild in your mind, sound in mind. Don't delay and procrastinate. There's the danger of what? Delaying. We call it procrastination. Procrastination is what? In the Philippines, we call that mañana habit. Bukas lang. Tomorrow only. I'll do it tomorrow. And tomorrow never comes. When you die,
I'm sad.
I have talked to a good number of people. Few, maybe a year ago, or a year and a half ago. I've got a contact just in mind that in our neighborhood, the high-rise building near our house, a lady was in depression because of marital problems and whatever. So I prayed with her and all that. And soon as she made decision for Christ, she said, "Could you also talk to my dad?" And I said, "Where is your dad?" And she said, "My dad is in the hospital, but he is few days from now discharged by the hospital and decided hopeless because of his advanced cancer, 4 stage. So he was dying. He was in the home now. And I said, once he gets home, then I'll go." So we did. I went there. The dad. And he was at the time, talked to him in his dying house in the apartment. Must be late 70s. Must be 75, 76. So I said, I introduce myself. I'm a preacher. I love Jesus and I'd like you to know and love Jesus too. And then I presented to him the way of salvation and two destinies I have. This brevity of life, so sure. The surety of death. The curse of sin and hell that awaits people. Or judged because of sin, and the remedy in Christ, from the curse of sin. That's by faith in Jesus. And Jesus will forgive you if you believe in him. Believe me, he will, as he promised. So he made it clear, I made it clear to him. And then I said, I pressed for his decision, choice. I said, why don't you don't make that decision right now? Of course, he was dying. Any time. So to me, that was urgent. I don't want to delay. Again and again. And you know what I said? I ask him, you understand? Yes. Will you make the decision? Will you believe in Jesus? And he said, because he couldn't say it, he couldn't speak anymore. He said, so again, pleaded with him.
Because of the urgency. Because hell is not a joke. Because destiny is determined when you are still alive.
So I again repeated. Then I pressed, pleaded with him. He wouldn't. Three times. He wouldn't. I will not force you. And Jesus will not force anyone. So I said, I hope I'm not leaving, but I hope and pray that you will change your mind. You know, a day after, the daughter informed me to be the diet. My heart was broken.
Because we know where people want to go after death without Christ.
The Apostle Paul says, you will go into a hopeless and Christless eternity. So my challenge for you is, how important it is for us to really believe Jesus.
You have friends. Maybe you have an unbelieving husband. Or wife, unbelieving children, unbelieving employers, or neighbors, relatives, close friends. You know where they are going after death without Christ. So we see here the urgency. The Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 2. 2 Corinthians 6, verse 2. What did he say? Today is an accepted or favorable time. Today is the day of salvation. Do not say tomorrow, tomorrow. Lest the devil might harden your heart tomorrow. Lest he might allure and deceive you that you will say no tomorrow. Right now. Because we want people to be ready to meet their God. Amos 4:12 says, Amos chapter 4, verse 12, prepare to meet your God. Are you prepared?
Amen.
How about your neighbors? How about your classmate? How about your fellow worker in your office? For 20 years now, that's the story of one believer, one friend of mine, a brother of the Lord. There was a baptismal service in the church. The testimony of the baptismal candidate said, I should have accepted Jesus Christ long time ago. Because, and he mentioned one of the members there in church. We were together for almost 20 years now in the office, but he never told me about Jesus. I only came to know about Jesus from others. We were always together. We had coffee together. We talked about it. We were dead. Isn't it a shame? I tell you, we will be given account for that. Their hands must be, the blood must be in our hands if we don't care about Jesus. So I hope that this will revolutionize each one of us. Just to think about life is short. Two destinies. Death is so certain. After that, judgment. For unbelievers, I hope that we will do the business. We are here, brothers and sisters, called to be saved, right? We are saved. And we are saved to serve, to witness. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, put your hand of blessing on this story. So many fruits. We have just started on the scraps. Thank you, Lord, that you have once again refreshed us encourage us and embolden us to really go out and pray and witness. Find ways and means that our loved ones, our friends, our acquaintances, our office mates will hear the gospel of salvation. In Jesus' name, amen.
Marcelo.